Hello dear students, assalamu alaikum. I'm your maths teacher. So today I will study from day one mathematics, 7th edition. Right? So we are on exercise 1B today. So page number is 21. And this is a basic level of exercise, right? So find the highest common factor of each of the following numbers, right? Numbers are given, so we have to find out HCF, highest common factor, right? So I have solved these questions for you, right? Find the highest common factors of each of the following. 12 and 30 are given, so taking their common prime factors, right? So separately we'll take common prime factors, and then we will take common factors. So taking common factors, 2 and 3 are common, 2, 3 is a 6, right? So this is first method. This second method also you can adopt, right? So by taking common prime factors through LCM by Dwin method, right? So taking LCM by Dwin method also you can find out the same answer, right? So then B part is there, 84 and 156. So highest common factor you have to find out, 84 and 56, taking their prime factors separately, then taking common. So common factors will be multiplied and integrated like this, right? So then C part, taking 15, 60 and 75 are given, taking their prime factors separately. So 15, 3, 5 is 15, 60. 2 multiply 2, 3, 5, and 75, 3 multiply 5, and multiply 5. So taking common, 3 and 5 are common factors, so 15 is HCF, highest common factor. Then D part, 77, 91, 143 are given, we'll take their prime factors, right? So taking separately the prime factors of each number, 77, 91, and 143. So here 1 is common only, rest of the numbers are not common, so we'll write down HCF 1. Then question number 2 here, find the lowest common multiple of each of the following numbers, right? So lowest, least common multiple we have to find out, LCM. So this is number 2. So question number 2, here we have to find out lowest common multiple or least common factor or multiple, you can say. So 24 and 30 are given, so taking their prime factors, so separately we have taken their prime factors, so 24 and 30. So these are, we will write the prime factors here in this form, and then we'll take common. So here 2 is common here, we'll write here, and then 3 is common. Right, 3 is common, right? So then 2 multiply 2, this is left, we will write this also. So in this, when you take least common multiple, you have to keep it in mind that the common factors and non-common factors all are multiplied. First you take common factors, then rest of the non-common factors you also multiply. So this is second method I have given, so answer is same, LCM. Then B part here, 42 and 462 are given, so take their prime factors, then take common, and then write answer. So both the method, any method you can adopt, so the answer will be same. Then C part is given, 12, 18, 81, so take their prime factors separately, take common, non-common factors also, multiply them, and you will get the answer. Then LCM by Dwin method also you can take, right? So this method you can adopt if you want. Then D part is given, 63, 80, 102. Take their prime factors, right? Then take common of the given prime factors, and then take non-common factors also. Then multiply and you will get the answer. So this is LCM by Dwin method also you can solve. The answer will be same. So this is all for today. We'll see you in the next video. Thank you.